Hi friends, today I am going to discuss about Wilms tumor, which is also known as nephroblastoma. Wilms tumor. This is the most common abdominal malignancy of children who are more than 1 year of age. Most common abdominal malignancy of children more than 1 year of age, and in infants that is less than 1 year of age, neuroblastoma is more common. In more than 1 year of age, nephroblastoma, that is Wilms tumor, is more common. There are two genes, WT1 and WT2 genes on chromosome number 11. This is the important thing, hospital names, WT1 and WT2 genes. These are tumor suppressor genes. Any deletions, mutations in these genes will result in the formation of this Wilms tumor. Coming to the WT1 deletion, this results in a syndrome called WAGR syndrome, which comprises of the features like Wilms tumor, aniridia, that is absence of Wilms tumor, aniridia, and that is absence of iris, and genitourinary anomalies. G means genitourinary anomalies. Genitourinary anomalies. And coming to the R, that is retardation, mental retardation. WT1 deletion is related to leads to Wagner syndrome, Wilms tumor, aniridia, genitourinary abnormalities, and mental retardation. Coming to the WT1 mutation, this leads to Danish-Dash syndrome. This leads to Danish-Dash syndrome, which comprises of male pseudohermaphroditism, early onset nephrotic syndrome, and Wilms tumor. This mutation in Danish-Dash syndrome, Wilms tumor plus male pseudohermaphroditism and early onset nephrotic syndrome will be seen. Coming to WT2 gene mutation, this results in Beckwith-Wiedemann syndrome. In this, Wilms tumor, microglossia, that is a large tongue, organomegaly, and hemi-hyperplasia of organs can be seen. This is all this comes under Beckwith-Wiedemann syndrome, that is seen in WT2 mutation. Coming to them, as I already said, Wilms tumor is also known as nephroblastoma, which is the most common abdominal malignancy in children more than 1 year. Coming to the clinical features, abdominal lump, painless smooth abdominal lump will be the most common presentation. The triad of symptoms here is lump, fever, and hematuria. Hematuria is also present, but the most common presentation is painless smooth abdominal lump. Lump, fever, hematuria are the triad. Hypertension is also accompanying in some cases, mostly unilateral, and 5 to 10% may be bilateral. This tumor metastasizes mostly to the lung through blood, that is hematogenous spread of the carcinoma may occur. And coming to the most important determinant of prognosis in Wilms tumor is histology. This question is also asked in AIIMS 2014. Histology is the most important determinant of prognosis in Wilms tumor. As it is a carcinoma, surgery is the choice of therapy. Epithelial type has good prognosis. Epithelial type of Wilms tumor has good prognosis. As it is a carcinoma, surgery is the treatment of choice, and in advanced cases, chemotherapy should be given and radiotherapy should be given. The chemotherapeutic agents of choice are actinomycin D, that is adactinomycin, and doxorubicin and vincristine may also be used in these cases. And the one thing I forget to tell is these arise from the embryonic nephrogenic tissue from abnormal proliferation of metanephric blastema. This is an embryonic structure, and this tumor arises from this thing. Thank you for watching, and please subscribe to my channel if you like the video. Thank you and have a nice day.